Welcome everybody. Come on in, come on in, come on in. Invite somebody to join. Come on in. Blessings to everyone. Blessings to everyone. Go ahead and share the broadcast with someone. Go ahead and share the broadcast with someone. Guess what? I was trying to go to sleep. I was busy. Well, actually, I was just trying to mind my own business. I was trying to mind my own business and go to sleep. I just came from church and a good day, Portia. I just came from church and guess what? Today was my pastor's birthday and we celebrated his 47th birthday and we had an awesome time in church. We had some eats after church, so I just got home from church and guess what? All I wanted to do, I'm feeling a little luggy. So all I wanted to do was come on in and just go to bed. You know, hey, bestie, how you doing? Hey, Miss Clark, how you doing? Guess what? All I wanted to do was come on in and go to bed. Guess what? I done take off my clothes and I done ready for bed. Guess what? And I have an unction. I just couldn't lay down because the Spirit of the Lord just kept on talking to me and he kept on saying to me, he said, I need you to go ahead and pray for my people. And God knows I really didn't want to get up. I didn't want to put on my clothes. I did not want to come back here. I just wanted to wash my face and go to sleep. So listen here, I'm only coming on in for a few minutes being obedient to the Holy Spirit. I'm only going to come on in for a few minutes because he wants me to pray for our finances. Amen. I'm hearing the Spirit of the Lord saying that there are a lot of jobs that he is going to release to you. Amen. And he said as a result, most of you was a part of the 21-day prayer. My God, I'm hearing the Holy Spirit. Because you were a part of the 21 days of prayer, he said, because of it, I'm about to reward you. He said, I am a rewarder of those that diligently seek me. I am a rewarder. He said, I am the reward of your worship. I am the reward of your prayer. Amen. I'm hearing the Holy Spirit speaking to me as I speak to you now. I had no intentions of coming on in. And he says to me now, he said, say to my people that I am a rewarder. I am the reward of their worship. I am the reward of their praise. I am the reward of their prayers. So because of the 21 days of prayer that you participated, go ahead and share the broadcast with somebody. Somebody needed this. I'm just feeling an unction in my spirit just to pray. Amen. I'm feeling an unction in my spirit just to pray. Go ahead, double the numbers, man. Come on, invite somebody. If you've been on this live feed and you never invited or never shared a broadcast, this is your opportunity to go and do that now. Guess what? I am in my bedroom. You all could notice I did not even go in front of the computer because God knows I really did not want to come out. But I'm being obedient to the Spirit of the Lord. And he is saying that I am God is a reward. I am the reward of your prayer. I am the reward of your worship. I am the reward of it. So he said, as a result, for many of you, you were a part of the 21 days of prayer challenge. And he said, because of your prayer, I am the reward. So God is saying to you, I am not going to reward you. He said, I am the reward. God Jehovah himself is the reward. So I just wanted to come on in. And he spoke to my spirit a few minutes ago. And he said that I want to bless my people. Amen. He said that I want to bless my people, but my people refuse to give up certain things. Amen. I'm hearing the Spirit of the Lord saying, before I can bless you, there are some things that you need to release. Before I can move some things in your life, there are some mountains that you need to move out of your way. And he said that you need to bring up your faith level. For many of you on the broadcast, he said that you need to come up a little higher when it comes to your faith. You need to come up a little higher when it comes to your worship. He said you need to come a little higher when it comes to your worship time. He said that I desire to spend more times with you. He said that I desire to spend more time with you. He said that I desire to hear more from you. He said I desire for you to sing to me more often. He said I desire to hear your voice more often. He said I need more of you. In order for me to remove some mountains, in order for me to move for you, in order for me to break some barriers, in order for me to break some generational curses off of your life, I need you to come up higher. He said time for playing church and time for playing games and time for just coming to church just to look good, that is over. He said time for coming to church and just looking good, that is over. He says time for coming to church and just being vain is over. Time for coming to church and just lifting up hands that are not holy before me, it is over. He said that judgment is, he said it is not about to begin in my house, he said, but it has already begun in my house. He said, and I will wipe away, I God will wipe away. He said, I God, Jesus. He said, I God, judgment has begun in my house. And he said that I will remove and I will replace mantle, says the Spirit of the Lord. He said, because I've been calling my people, says the Spirit of the Lord, to come up higher, and they refuse to come up higher. And he said, I desire for you to come up higher, my child. I desire to hear your voice. I desire to, Jesus. He said, I desire to wipe away your tears. I desire to give you what you are praying for. I desire to give you what you are praying for. He said, but first you got to come up a little higher. But first you got to know me. But first you got to seek my face and not my hands. He said that if you seek my face, I will release what I have in my hands. He said that if you seek my face, if you seek my face, then I will release what I have in my hands. He said, for most of you, you are trapped up in so much bondage. You have so much chains around you and you can't even move. You feel like every time you take 10 steps forward, you taking 20 steps backwards. And he said that you are all wrapped up. And for some of you, he said, for some of you, you are so wrapped up in bondage. You are so filled with bondage. And he said, because you are so locked down and there's so much chains around you, you can't even move. And he said, my child, I desire to set you free. I desire to break those chains. He said, but the covenants that you've made with our false idols, the covenant that you've made with false God, the covenants that you made with other gods, the covenants that you made with those witchcraft doctors, the covenants that you made with the witch doctors, the covenant that you made, he said that you got to break those covenants. You got to break yourself loose of certain things. You got to break yourself loose of certain things, for I, God, want to set you free. But he cannot step down into a situation that is a mess. So sometimes you got to go and you got to release some things. That guy that he's telling you to get rid of, you need to get rid of it. Amen. You need to get rid of it. He said that if you don't get rid of it, I will break your heart, says the Spirit of the Lord. If you don't get rid of him, I, the Lord, will break your heart. Amen. And you might say, Minister Marva, how in the world you can say that the Lord say that he will break my heart? Trust me, I've been there and I've done that. When the Lord tell you to release something and you refuse to release it, he will take it away from you. For some of you, he's saying that, man, I am telling you, I am speaking to you in dreams and in visions, and I'm showing you signs that this is not the person that I want in your life. This is not the person that should be in your life. He said that I've spoken to you over and over. He said that I've spoken to your ear over and over. He said even in the night I have visited you, and I've told you and I've warned you. And he said if you refuse to cut it, he said, I the Lord will cut it myself. So most of you may be saying, this woman out of order, what in the world is she talking about? What, you got to be going out of your mind. The Lord himself will break your heart. Guess what? If the job was not meant for you and he's been telling you to get rid of the job, if he's been telling you to get out of the job and go and open up your own business, this is the time and the season to be obedient to God. So guess what? I was laying down, guess what? And the Spirit was on me. So I mean, I just couldn't even do nothing else. I tossed and I turned and I was like, Lord, just loose me, because I just want to go and lay down and go sleep. And I just said, Lord, just loose me. Guess what? Would I even say that for? Because I can't even sleep now. Shit, did it make it? See? So the Lord said, in order for me to move in your life, there are some things that you need to cut away. There are some things that you need to give up. Guess what? Cry about it. Cry about it. And then put on your big girl underwears. Cry about it. And then put on your big boy's underwear and get over it. Because there are some things that I want to do for you in this season
but you must release the past. Amen. You must release the rejection. You must release the hurt. You must release those things that are of the past and let them go in order for me to push you and propel you towards your destiny. Amen. In order for me to push you towards your destiny, he said that you got to let go of the past, because I want to issue you. I want to propel you in your future. Amen. I want you to get on the path in order for you to be at a place where you can commune with me. There are some things that you need to let go of in order to come up. Amen. In order for you to come up, you need to let go of the weight so that you can be free, so that you can be light, so that you may be able to come on up. So the Spirit of the Lord is saying to you today, I desire to set you free. I desire to break those chains, but you need to let go of those covenants. For those of you and for people that will watch this broadcast later, and for people that are even in the churches that are going to the witch doctors to try to kill your own sisters and try to put down your own brothers, and for you, just because you see them have a business, or because you see them have a nice car, or because you see that they have a marriage and you desire the same thing, guess what the Lord is saying to you? If you want it, come to me. If you want it, come to me. He said, seek my face and then I will give you what's in my heart. Amen. He said, seek my face and then I will give you what's in my heart. Man, come on. We need to stop going to the witch doctors. Amen. Because they cannot give us what we need. Amen. For most of us, our spirits are so tied up. We are so caught up. And the reason why we are caught up is because we done been to the witch doctors. We done been to the voodoo man. We done been to the Obeah man, and as a matter of just because we done been to the Obeah man, we done sell our soul and don't even know it. Guess what? We done sell our soul and we don't even know it. So what you want the man to do now when his hand is tied behind his back? Don't you understand? When you done take a situation out of God's hand, he cannot even do anything with it. Amen. It's just like when a police officer locks you up and they place a cuff on you. Amen. Guess what? The police officer cannot just take the cuffs off and just let you go just like that. Amen. He cannot just let you go just like that. There's certain things that he needs to do. Amen. He needs to take you into custody. And after he takes you into custody, he needs to interview you. Amen. And after he interview you, then he charges you. After you are charged, then he puts you before the magistrate. Amen. After you are charged, the police officer himself cannot just go and release you for certain matters. For minor matters, yes. But there's certain matters that a police officer cannot release you. So you have to go before a magistrate. And God is saying to you today, I want to be the magistrate in your life. Why? Because the magistrate have the right, or the magistrate can give the order whether you are set free, or the magistrate can determine how long you will be sentenced to a prison, or how long you have to do a community service. The magistrate will determine that. So God is saying to some of you, guess what? Let me be the magistrate in your life. So much of you have handcuffs on you, and guess what? You're trying to get loose, or you're trying to get free out of those handcuffs, and guess what? No one can take those handcuffs out of you except for the persons that have the authority or the key to unlock those. My God, I feel the presence of God. Only the person that have the key to those handcuffs will be able to release you from whatever bondage you are in. So I'm telling you today that God has the keys to the bondage that you are in now. Whatever it is that you are walking in, whatever it is that you are going through today, I want you to know that bondage, whatever it is that you are facing today, that shackle that is around your feet, that shackle that is around your neck, that cuff that is around your hand, I'm telling you today that God have the keys. Amen. He has the keys and he wants to set you free. But first you got to surrender your own will. Amen. But first you got to surrender your own will, and you have to make your will, you have to make God's will your will. I always say to you on this line, guess what? When you come to Christ, you have to now die in your flesh, meaning now that you have to release your will and live out God's will. Amen. His desire has to now become your desires. Amen. His desire has to now become your desire. His will has to now become your will in order for you to walk the predestined plan that he has for your life. So today, as I'm under the unction of the Holy Spirit, I want to say a prayer, and I want to speak or declare some things in the atmosphere over your lives concerning your finances. Amen. Because so much of you are in burden, so much of you are in lack, and you don't even know what you're going to do. But some of you trying to pull out your hair right right as I'm speaking to you right now. You trying to pull out your hair because you don't know how you can feed your children. You don't know what you can send them to school with tomorrow. You don't know how you're going to pay the rent tomorrow. The people then don't call you from the bank and tell you they're coming to get the house. So if they don't call you from the bank and tell you they're coming to get the car, and you have no idea what to do. So I'm saying to you today that God desires to set you free from the things that you are dealing with. Amen. The things that you are dealing with, the bondages that you find yourself in, God is willing and he is here to set you free today. Amen. For those of you that are sending me prayer requests, God saying that he is about to move on your behalf. Yesterday, the Lord said to me, he said, say to my people that yes, I'm about to do it. And I said, what you talking about? And to me, the feeling that I got was, it was none of your business. Somebody yesterday asked God to do something, and he said, I am about to do it. Whoever it was for, they caught it and they catch it and they run with it. If it wasn't for you, then it wasn't for you. Guess what? When God says certain things, you have to be able to catch it in your spirit. Amen. You have to be able to catch it in your spirit. For some of you, I want to pray for you reference to your finances. Amen. I want to pray for you reference to your finances, because a lot of you, you are going through financially. Guess what? And I'm one of them too. You are going through financial. It's just that I decide now to make God my head cornerstone. I decide to now stop worrying and release anger, release frustration, and release worry and rely on God. I told you all just the other day, I walk into the food store and guess what? I walk out with 3 bags of grocery. I refuse to worry about the things that God told me not to worry about. Guess what? He said that I could feed the birds. The grass don't worry about where they're getting their color from or that green color from. The trees don't wonder where the next sunlight coming from. So why us as creatures of God, or as the creation of God, why are we concerned about what we can wear, what we can eat, and how the bills can get paid? No, my Father owns this whole planet. So why am I concerned about what am I going to put on my belly, in my belly? Why am I concerned about where the bills, where the money coming from to pay the rent? No, it is not my position. It's an insult to God now for me to sit down and worry about the things that he said that he will take care of. Amen. It is an insult to God for me to sit down and worry about the things that he said that he will take care of. So today I want to pray with you. I want to pray for you. For some of you, listen here, we already prayed that some of you, some checks have been holed up, and God said that those checks are about to be released. Amen. For some of you, this very week, for one or two of you, this very week, you can call me and you can let me know, woman of God, I received the check that I've been waiting on for months, the check that I've been waiting on for a year, the check that I've been waiting on for weeks. This same very week is the beginning that God is about to release some things that have been holed up. The enemy has been holding on to your money. He's been holding on to your finances. And God said, guess what? Hand it over to me. Leave it alone and I will release it. Amen. Leave it to me and I will deal with it. Leave it to me and I will handle it. Put it in my hands and leave it alone. Put it in my hands, turn around and leave it alone. And for some of you, come on now, let's begin to give God praise. Let's begin to give God glory for what he is about to do. Let's begin to magnify. You all know how we do this on the screen. Begin to show the love. Begin to show the hearts on the screen, and begin to show the thumbprints on the screen. That's basically us saying to God that we appreciate him and we thank him for what he is about to do. Guess what? I'm telling you right now that God is about to release some things to you. Some things that has been holed up. Guess what? And some things been holed up in your life because of generational curses. Some things been holed up in your life because of soul ties. Some things been holed up in your life because of the people that you've been around. Some things been holed up in your life because you refuse to let go of some people that God has told you to let go of. So come on, let us give God praise for what he is about to do. Come on. For some of you, he is about to break some relationships. For some of you, he is about to bust open some doors. For some of you, he's about to give you that car you've been praying for. For about few of you on this line, he's about to give you the husband that you've been praying for. He said, listen here, the person that you have in mind, or the identity, or the you know how we women is doing. We have a whole list of what we want. And God is saying, what you want is not what I want for you. And set aside that rule. Set aside that this is my type. Listen here, in this season, God is not coming to give you your type, but he's going to give you somebody after his own heart. Amen. He's going to bless you with a man or a woman of God after his own heart. A man or a woman of God that will be able to push you, that will be able to pray with you when you're not able to do it. When you're on the ground feeling hurt and feeling pain, guess what? God is sending you a man or a woman that will be able to pray with you, that will be able to push you forward, that will be able to birth you in the spirit. Ain't nothing is more frustrating as a man of God, that you have a woman on the side of you and you going through something and you can't even explain to her what you are going through, and she don't even have the spirit of discernment, or she's not even in the spirit in order to be able to figure out what it is that you are going through. Come on, in this season, it ain't the type that you want. Yeah, you want the nice booty and you want the nice hip and you want the big tits. Yeah, but God is saying, I am giving you somebody after my own heart. Somebody that will be able to birth you in the spirit. Amen. Somebody that will be able to pray you out. Amen. For most of you, God said, and he's saying in my ear now, that I have given you assignments and I have given you a mantle. And he said, the persons that I'm putting in your life are going to help you to birth that assignment. Amen. Help you to birth that assignment and help you to carry that mantle. Yeah, they may not look like the tall, dark and handsome that you've been looking for, but guess what? He might be a little short. He might have a little belly, but guess what? He is going to come and help you with that assignment. Amen. He's going to help you carry that mantle. So in this season, we need to drop this thing where this person don't look like my type and I ain't even interested. For some of you, you already shut down your blessing. Amen. You already shut down your blessing. In this season, come on, man, y'all need to open up your eyes in the spirit. Stop looking with your natural eye and open up your eye in the spirit. Amen. God has already sent the man of God or the woman of God in your life, and guess what? Y'all done passed by that person because y'all saying, oh, he ain't my type and she ain't my type. God saying now on this line, for some of you, y'all can let me know. In a few months, y'all can let me know. Send me the invitation, eh? For some of you, you are about to step into marriage, amen? You are about to step into marriage, and people will look at you and say, boy, this person don't even look like your type. This person ain't even look like your type. Guess what? God saying that it is all my doing, amen? It is all my doing. And the confirmation to you that you will know that it is him and that it is God is just that every door will open, amen? When it comes to the payment, when it comes to getting your dress, when it comes to getting the suit, when it comes to getting your whatever it is that you are supposed to get, reference to your wedding, the confirmation to you will be everything just as easy. Everything just as easy. Doors just will open to you, reference to your wedding. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. Receive it now. For most of you, for about a few of you on this timeline, I'm hearing the number five. For most of you, for about five of you on this timeline, you're going to say to me in another couple of weeks or another couple of months, woman of God, I'm about to get married, and it was so easy. Amen. It was so easy. That will be the confirmation. Amen. That will be the confirmation. Come on, let us give God praise. Come on, let us give God glory for what it is that he is about to do. My God, listen, yeah, I just wanted to go to sleep, but the spirit would not let me go to sleep. So guess what? I'm going to pray for your finances. For those of you that have your prayer request, you can continue to send your prayer request, because even after I come off of the line, I'm going to be praying for most of you. For most of you, you've been on the job and some finances been held back, and you need those finances. This is the time when you need those finances. Guess what? The Lord is about to release those finances. Amen. For those of you, you've applied to certain jobs and you've been waiting for a reply. God said, listen here, I'm about to give you those jobs. For some of you, you need to go right back to that same place that you've applied tomorrow morning. Amen. For most of you, you need to go right back to that place that you've applied. Guess what? I hear the spirit of the Lord say, put on a suit and go right back to that place, to that business establishment, first thing in the morning. Amen. You'll be surprised. Somebody can call me tomorrow and say, guess what, woman of God, I got the job. Put on that suit. Amen. I'm hearing the spirit of the Lord saying, put on the suit and go right back to the very place that you applied. The very place that you applied. He said, the one that you want. He said, not the one that you feel will take care of your financial obligation. The one that you really want. Put on your suit and go back to that place first thing tomorrow morning. Amen. First thing tomorrow morning. Come on, receive it now in the name of Jesus. Come on, receive it now in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you praise. Father, we give you the glory. Father, we give you the honor. We give you the glory, for you are worthy and there is no one else like you. Father, we thank you for deliverance on this line today, God. We thank you for deliverance on this line today. We thank you for setting your people free today, God. We thank you, oh God, that you are beginning to break every burden, Father God, that you are loosing your people, Father God, that you are setting them free, Father God. You are setting your people free, Father God, when it comes to their finances, oh God, when it relates to their finances, Father God. We thank you, oh God. We pray and we pray right now, Father God, that you would break, Father God, and that you would rebuke the devourer right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you praise. We give you glory. Father, everything that has been holed up, everything in the spiritual realm that has been holed up, every demonic force, every demon, every witch, every warlock that has been sent against your people to hold up their blessing, to hold up their blessing and to steal away their blessings in this season, we break it right now in the name of Jesus. Every generational curse over your people that says to them that they will never be successful, they'll never be able to have finances, they'll never be able to open up a business, they'll never be able to be married, Father, we break that right now in the name of Jesus. We curse every fight. We curse every generational curse right now, and we send it back to the pits of hell from whence it come right now in the name of Jesus. Now, God, we ask, oh God, that you will enlarge the territory of your people now in the name of Jesus. We ask, oh God, that you will enlarge the territory of your people right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you right now for promotion right now in the name of Jesus. I hear the Spirit of the Lord saying that you are about to get promoted. There's some people on this line, you're about to be promoted on your job. Guess what? There's some people speaking and saying that you will not be promoted. I want you to know in this season, amongst the people that are saying that you will not be promoted, guess what? You are about to be promoted in the presence of your enemies. Amen. You are about to be promoted in the presence of your enemies. For some of you, you even being promoted spiritually. Amen. You even being promoted spiritually. So you may be on a job and you saying, guess what? I did not get promoted on my job. But guess what? You are being promoted spiritually. Amen. You realize that you are on another level spiritually. Father, we give you thanks. We give you glory. We give you honor for what you are doing or what you are about to do. Father, we say, move on this line, Father God. Move in the lives of your people, Father God. For there are people on this line, Father God, that have financial obligations to meet, Father God. There are some people, Father God, that have some financial obligation to meet reference to the bank, Father God. We ask, oh God, that you will go, Father God, and you will move in their lives like never yet before, oh God. Every yoke, every burden, Father God, lift it right now in the name of Jesus. For your people, Father God, that is worrying right now, Father God, I cast away that spirit of worry right now in the name of Jesus. For you said in your word, Father, to take no care for where we would eat and what we would wear, Father God. So today, Father God, we rely on your word. We stand on your word, Father God. We rely on your word and we stand on your word, for we know that you are not a man that you should lie. Amen. We know that you are not a man that you should lie. And you said in your word that you put your word above your very own name. So today, oh God, we rely on your word, Father God. We speak your word into the atmosphere, Father God, that says whatever we ask, we shall receive, Father God. We speak your word in the atmosphere, Father God, that says that we are the head and not the tail, Father God. We speak your word in the atmosphere that said that we are the lender and not the borrower, Father God. So we declare your word in the atmosphere today. We declare your word in the atmosphere today. And we say, Father God, that we are victorious in the area of our finances now. We are victorious in the area of our finances now in the name of Jesus. Release every burden, Father God. Release every burden, Father, in the name of Jesus. Release every yoke right now and break every yoke right now in the name of Jesus. Every worry, every spirit of anxiety, every spirit of depression, Father, we break it right now in the name of Jesus. Father, for that person right now that the landlord say, guess what, you only have a few more days to get out of the apartment, Father, we ask, oh God, that you would begin to move on that person's behalf right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we know, Father God, that you are, Father God, that you hear the words of the prophet, Father God, that just like Elijah, Father God, when he prayed for rain, Father God, when he prayed for rain, Father God, it rained from heaven, Father God. So today, Father God, as I stand here as a woman of God, as I stand here in prayer, as I stand here in the gap for your people, Father God, I say, Father God, honor the words, Father God, and we thank you, oh God, for honoring our words and hearing our prayers, Father God. You said in your word, Father God, that you will honor, that you will hear the prayer, Father God, of those that diligently seek you, Father God. So we are seeking you today. We are seeking your face today, Father God. We are not seeking your hands today, but Father, but we are seeking your face today, Father God. So we say today, Father God, that we rely on your word, Father. We rely on your word, Father God. We make your desire our desire, Father God, and we make your will our will today in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you praise. We give you glory. Thank you for the open doors, Father God. Thank you for the promotions, Father God. Thank you for the marriages, Father God. Thank you for the jobs, Father God. Thank you for the vehicles that you're about to provide, Father God. Thank you for all that you are about to do, Father God. We magnify you because it is already done in the spiritual realm. So we come into agreement, Father God. We come into agreement right now, Father God. You said it. It said in your word, Father God, how can two walk together if they do not agree? So I agree with your persons, with the persons on this line right now. I come into agreement with the persons on this line right now that everything that they are praying for and every prayer request will be met now in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you the praise. We give you the glory. We give you the honor. We magnify you, O God. We thank you, O God, for doing it, Lord. Let's give God some praise. Let's give God some honor. Let's give God some glory for what it is that he is about to do. Amen. Yes, Daniel, we are walking under an open heaven. Amen. We are walking under an open heaven. heaven. Guess what? And when you are walking under an open heaven, guess what that means? That means that God is about to pour you out a blessing that you do not have room to contain. Amen. And when you don't have any room to contain, you know what you need to do? You need to start sharing. Amen. You need to start sharing. God does not only bless you just to bless you. Amen. He bless you so that you can be a blessing to the people around you. So guess what? For some of you, God has already opened the door. Amen. He has already opened the door, and he is opening the door for some of you. Guess what? And when you are walking under an open heaven, God pours you out a blessing that you have room not to contain. Guess what? Not for you just to keep it all for yourself, but for you to bless others. Amen. For you to get your family out of poverty. Amen. For you to get your co-workers out of poverty. For you to get your church members out of poverty. Amen. For you to get that sister that you know only wear one pair of shoes to church, to get her out of poverty. Amen. It is for you to pull somebody else up out of their poverty state. Amen. So I just wanted to come on in for a few minutes and pray with you. Guess what? God is about to release the finances. Amen. He is about to release the finances. So come on, let us give God some praise. It says in the word of God that when the praises go up, the blessings come down. Amen. So come on, let's take a few minutes right before I come offline and give God praise. Father, we give you praise. Father, we magnify you. Father, we glorify you. Father, we say today that we love you. We appreciate you. We thank you, oh God, for everything that you're about to do. Father, we thank you, oh God, that you are the Lion of Judah. We thank you, oh God, that you are the same God, Father God, that deliver, Father, you, Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac, the same way that you delivered them, Father God, the same way that you was a covenant keeper to them, Father God. We realize and we know, Father God, that you are a covenant keeper today. So come on, let us give God praise. Let us give God glory for what he is about to do. Amen. For what he is about to do. Come on, some mountains are about to move out of our way. Amen. Some doors that the enemy closed is about to be opened. Amen. Guess what? Who can close a door that God opens? Amen. So come on, let us magnify the Lord. Amen. Come on, let us magnify the Lord for what he is about to do. Amen. Come on, let us magnify the Lord. It was a blessing to see all of you today. Continue to share the broadcast with somebody. Guess what? I just wanted to go to my bed, but thank God I was obedient to the Spirit of the Lord. Amen. I am looking forward to hearing from you. I'm looking forward to hearing the good reports and the good news. I am looking forward to hearing from some of you. Amen. I am looking forward to hearing as early as tomorrow afternoon. I'm looking forward to hearing the good news from some of you, because you know a lot of people now, they would come and they would get the word and they would never return. Remember now, Jesus, I think he healed a few people, right? And he sent them away. And when he sent them away, I guess, I think it was only one that came back to thank him, right? If I'm not mistaken. Titania, help me here. I think it was only one person that came back to say thank you. Amen. I'm not asking you to come back and say thank you, but all I want you to do is say, woman of God, the very thing that God spoke through you, it came through. Amen. The very thing that God spoke through your mouth, it has come through. It is not to glorify me, but it's to glorify God. Amen. It is to glorify God. And it's, guess what? As Christian people, we so like to keep seeking. And guess what? The world don't know what it is that God is doing for us. Come on, man. When God bless you, you show that off. Stop being secretive. Come on, stop being secretive. And stop saying, oh, they can try to kill me for what I have. Guess what? If God delivered you, then he can deliver you now. If he kept you from witchcraft, then he can keep you from witchcraft now. So whatever they tried then and it didn't work, if they try it now, it just ain't gonna work. So guess what? Come on, we need to learn how to magnify and glorify the God, the Lord, when he does something for us. Amen. So it is not to glorify Marva. Guess what? Marva is a nobody. Marva don't exist. When the Holy Spirit come in, Marva do not exist. It is for the Lord to be glorified. Amen. So y'all come back with your testimonies, man. Y'all come back with your testimony, because guess what? I am looking forward for somebody to come and put a couple thousand dollars in my hand and say, minister or sister, Marva, this is for you to pay off your conference. This is for you to do the conference. Because guess what, sisters and brothers? I don't only want to do the conference in Grand Bahama, but I also want to bring the conference in Abaco. And guess what? All of that take money, and I don't have it. All of that take money and finances. So when the Lord said to me just now to pray for finances, guess what? I'm praying hard for myself too. I am praying hard for myself, because guess what? There are some people around here in Abaco that are begging for me to do the conference here in Abaco. And guess what? It takes a lot of money. So guess what? I want to do the conference here in Abaco also. I'm doing it only for one night in Grand Bahama, but when I bring it here to Abaco, I'm going to do it for a 4-day period. Amen. For each speaker will be able to speak for one night, and they'll be able to elaborate on some stuff. Amen. In Grand Bahama, I'm not able to do that because I... four nights of doing a conference in Grand Bahama is very expensive. So guess what? A man of God who God has already sent to open the door to his church to me, he has opened the door for me. So I'm able to come now and to bring the conference to Abaco, and we'll be able to do a four-night service of the conference. Amen. We'll be able to do, guess what? It will be like a conference / revival, because guess what? Some stuff can happen inside that place. Guess what? So guess what? I can't do it all by myself. So when God say pray for finances, he knows why he's saying it. Amen. It means that he has already released it. So now we need to go in warfare for it to be released out of the atmosphere. Amen. So when God tells you to pray for finances, it isn't because he wants you just to go and make a bunch of noise and cry out and ask him for it. No, it is because he has already released it, because he has already seen the need. Amen. Remember, he is all seeing. He has already seen the need. He has already sent it. And because there's a fight, there's a spiritual fight going on up there, we need to pray and we need to warfare in order to pull it down. Amen. In order to pull it down. So that's basically what was happening today. Amen. So when we pray and when you send your prayer request, it isn't that God didn't already do it. He has already sent it. Amen. He has already sent it. Now we just have to go and warfare and pull it out. Amen. So listen here, brothers and sisters. It was so good to see all of you. Like I said, the conference is going to be in Grand Bahama. The roundtable discussion is going to be on the 22nd of July, and the conference itself is going to be on the 28th of July. Come out at those conferences, man. Come on, you will be blessed. Come on. We have Minister Ewing that will be in the house. We have Pastor Glenn Russell that will be in the house. You have Prophetess Talia Boleg that will be in the house. Come on. You don't want to miss the fire. Amen. You don't want to miss this fire in this season. So if you want to be on your way to walking into your destiny, or if you are already walking in your destiny and you want to be able to be propelled further ahead in your destiny, come on out to the roundtable discussion and to the Walking into Destiny conference. Amen. And then we're going to try to do it here in Abaco. And guess what? A few people have been calling me from Nassau, and they want us to bring the conference in Nassau. We'll see what the Lord says. However the Lord provides, if he provides and if he open up a door, we will be taking the conference to Nassau also. So a blessings to all of you. Guess what? God is about to do it. Amen. God is about to do it. He is about to do it. I'm looking forward to hearing from some of you. Blessings to all of you. I love you. Thank you for coming on and share the broadcast with somebody. Blessings to all of you. Guess what? If you want to be a blessing to the ministry, my friend Miller, she put up the information here. Look here, D'Angela. Yes. If the door is open, then we come into Nassau. If the door is open, guess what? If God is opening the door to Nassau, because a few people have been telling me that they, you know, they really, really would appreciate if the conference come to Nassau. So if the Lord opens a door, then we will be in Nassau also. Amen. So we will be in Grand Bahama, we will be in Abaco, and then we will be in Nassau if the Lord's willing. Amen. So blessings to all of you. Guess what? The PayPal information is on the screen. If you want to be a blessing to the ministry, go ahead on PayPal. If you have a PayPal account, it is very easy. You can go and you can release your seed on the PayPal account, or you can just inbox me and I can give you my account information, and you can go ahead and you can do it on the you know, us behemoths, we like doing it the easy way. So we would prefer just to go to the bank and just put it on the account. So you can just inbox me and I'll give you that information. Blessings to all of you. It was so good to see all of you. Hey Michelle Duncombe, how you doing? Hey Renetta, blessings to see you all the time. It is always a blessing to see you. Latoya Ramming, it's a blessing to see you. Lawanda Smith, listen, how was everything on Saturday? How did it go? How everything went yesterday? I know that y'all had to go and bury your mom yesterday. How did everything go? And listen here, I prayed for your strength yesterday, Lawanda. I prayed for your strength yesterday, Lawanda, because I know how difficult it is, and I lost my mother also, so I know how difficult it is. Hey Laquisha, it was a blessing to see you, darling. Jen Roll, it's always a blessing to see you, honey. It's always a blessing to see you. And all of you, guess what? I can't just continue to say all of your name. Pauline, it's a blessing to see you. Corrine, all of y'all familiar names that I'm used to seeing, it is a blessing. And some new names I'm seeing, it is a blessing to see all of you. Guess what? Like I said, if you want to be a blessing to the ministry, follow the PayPal information or inbox me, and then I will give you the account information. But go ahead, man. I'm looking forward for you to testify. You remember in the old church how they used to do testimony service? Who remember those testimony service when you used to come up on the mic and you used to testify? Then you had mama them who wanted to be on the mic for about 10 minutes and never won. You all remember testimony service? Man, listen, you have some people, they look like they didn't ever wanted to stop talking. Barry! Hey, listen, y'all, Barry is on the line. She is at Ashes Beauty Loft. And guess what? She's located in the Regency. Is it Regent Center or the Regency Center? But anyway, she's located in the Regency Center in Freeport, right across from the post office. She has the tickets. Guess what, people? She has the tickets. Barry has the tickets to the roundtable discussion. The tickets are $30. You can go ahead and get your t-shirt. I mean, your tickets, and you will receive a Walking into Destiny t-shirt. When you come to the Walking roundtable discussion, you will receive your t-shirts. Amen. It trust me, you will love the t-shirts. You will love the t-shirts. It's a new design. And we haven't been getting these things prepared for you. So listen, go and see Barry down there at the it's the Regent Center. Go down there at the Regent Center. Her shop name is Ashes Beauty Loft. You can go down there to Ashes Beauty Loft and you can get your tickets. Amen. See Barry and you can get your tickets. Guess what? You could go down there and get your suits too. You get your whole outfit down there. You could, it's a one-stop shop. You go down there, get your outfit. You go down there, get your ticket, and you straight. Guess what? And she have some nice custom jewelry there also. So go down there and see Barry. She'll be able to assist you with your outfit. She'll be able to assist you with your ticket. She'll be able to assist you, and she can handle you with love. Amen. She's going to be able to handle you with love. So go ahead and see Barry down there at the Regent Center. Amen. Blessings to all of you, my bestie Nika. Guess what? Oh Lord, I know you get tired of me sometimes, bestie. I know you get tired of me sometimes because I always call her to do something for me. I'm not in Freeport, people. I'm in Abaco. So I'm always calling on my best friend to do something for me. So I pray that God bless her and that He multiply the blessings upon her life. Guess what? I just pray for my bestie more than I pray for myself. If y'all understand that type of, you know, friendship, I just pray for her more than I pray for myself. She has a wonderful spirit and she has a huge heart and she loves hard. You hear me? She loves hard. So I really do appreciate my best friend. I might not say it all the time, but I know she knows it. She knows it. I appreciate her truly from the bottom of my heart. I really do appreciate her. So guess what? Y'all go down there. Go and see Barry. Get your ticket, eh? I know how y'all be hearing people go, y'all like to wait for last minute. Go and see Barry. Get your ticket before all the other people them get the ticket and you ain't getting none. Go and get your ticket. It was a blessing to see all of you, man. Listen, your God is about to release the finances. Amen. He's about to release the flying finances. So go ahead. Enjoy the rest of your day. I know it's Sunday. For some of you, you done eat and you're ready to go and lay down. Blessings to all of you. Share the broadcast with somebody. If you want to be a blessing to the ministry, the information is on the screen. You can go ahead and follow it. Blessings to all of you.